We love
Oh, you know what? Bad gems not here.
Oh,
I got a Nicki Minaj story.
A real barb. Right? Let the barbs out.
We would have got an opinion from.
Oh my God, an official barb,
a member of the barb committee.
Vice president on the Canadian side.
Hold on, let me fix my mic here quick, fast, because it keeps on leaning down. It keeps on doing the floppy.
Yeah,
the floppy.
That. I don't like that.
Yeah, I need like some Blue Chew or something. Okay. I don't have it, the People magazine interview that she was talking about it in.
Okay.
Apparently she was, I was looking through the other interview that she did with Complex or one of those other places.
Yeah.
And I was trying to find it in there, but apparently it was in People magazine. Okay, so one second here. I'm just going through a freaking 20-second ad. Hold on.
That's
some for me and some for you.
Could be abused. Telling the mag, no one told past addiction issues. The 40-year-old rapper, Nicki Minaj, is opening up about her past addiction issues. The 40-year-old rapper spoke to Vogue for their December 2023 cover story about becoming addicted to the prescription pain medication Percocet years ago after being prescribed it for cramps.
Yeah, you can put it up on the screen.
And she didn't even realize the medication could be abused. Telling the mag, no one told me that this was a narcotic and this was addictive. Luckily, I was able to ground myself.
You can see it better.
But once an addict, always an addict. I feel like if you've ever experienced addiction to anything, which I have, you always have to think twice and three times about the choices that you make. Nicki also revealed how her father's substance abuse issues she witnessed as a child helped her to better understand addiction.
So she's saying she got on the Perky's post pregnancy or stuff like that, or I guess the cramps and stuff.
Yeah. After pregnancy?
Yeah.
Nah.
Lie. Or during pregnancy or
lie
whatever.
That.
And she didn't know it was a drug.
No, lie that.
You think she was on the Perky's before that?
Yeah, she got Meek Mill addicted.
Yes.
More times a girl broke them out. A girl breaks out.
Yeah, and from what you're saying, B3, she didn't know it was a drug. Like, I don't know. I don't know what to believe about that.
That's
a real thing, though.
That's synthetic, though. It's a synthetic number four.
No, but like as far as like people prescribing you Percocets for like an injury, pain, different things like that.
Yeah.
You start using it. You're like, okay, it's all good. I'm just using these Perkies now for the pain.
So her not knowing it was a perk.
No, not knowing that it was a perk, but knowing that it's an addictive drug.
Yeah.
Right? A lot of people don't realize. And that's how like the pharmaceuticals get you, right?
Yeah, for sure.
They'll be like, I watched a whole movie about this. I think it was called Pill or something on Netflix.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They give you the drugs for your pain. You mashed up your back and different things like that.
Yeah.
And after a while, your back's good, but now you're addicted to the Perkies and you can't stop taking them.
And then you're in pain.
Yeah.
And then you need it. It's just
No, you're not even in pain no more.
No. You will still feel the pain now.
You'll go back to.
Yeah. Cause once you don't have it, the pain, like, you know, say it gets cold or something, it's about to rain. Boom. You start feeling the pain in the knee or something.
Nah, fam. Like now you're just going through the withdrawals of the Perkies, and that's why you want them.
Okay, right? I get it.
Back pain and all that, like you could have been going through an injury, for example, like in this movie I was watching. I forget the name of the movie on
I remember
on Netflix. It came out not that long ago, right?
I remember it's like Pill.
It's like a three-part series or whatever. They had the one guy who owned a car mechanic shop, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he mashed up his back.
Yeah.
And the doctor prescribed him the Perkies, or it was not Percocet. It's the other one, OxyContin.
Yeah.
Right? He prescribed him that stuff.
Yeah.
Man was using that and like to, you know, numb the pain from his back.
Yeah.
After a while, he kept on going to go get refills, but this is way after the time that his back has been healed. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But now he's just addicted to the oxys. He can't stop taking them.
But it's just like if a person was using actual heroin, right? When they don't have it, they get sick, right?
Yeah.
And then they're in pain or whatever. It's the same way.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just that it's synthetic.
It's a placebo. Your body starts shutting down because it needs that.
Yeah. So the pain comes back. So like, for instance, if it was a knee injury, they're still going to resort to it being pain, like their knees hurting them. So that's why they need it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm trying to say?
But their knee ain't even hurting them no more, fam. Now it's just their stomach. Like, I need more shit.
Yeah, but then after they can't shit. When you use a lot of that shit, you get constipated, dog.
Mm.
You know what I mean? That's why you see mad niggas with, like, guts.
Bubble guts.
Yeah. Because But lean is the same thing.
Well, that's like synthetic heroin too.
That's synthetic heroin too.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing.
You see, the thing is, when it comes to this rap game,
yeah,
and like I feel for Nicki because it's easy to get into this shit.
Of course,
like. Especially all the different generations of rap, right? There's been different types of drugs that have been around.
In the 80s, it was like Kool G Rap, Mobb Deep, all of them. Mm-hmm. Everybody, the generational shit, right? But it's how they, now it was more put in your face than anything else, right?
Yeah.
Before they would be like, they'd probably be on it, but still saying, yo, you know, fight the power.
Yeah. But now people are, there's songs, Molly, Percocet, different things like that. It's accepted, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, you got all these young rappers that are coming up now. It's not a shady little secret to be like, oh, you know, I got a drug problem. Like, you could sing about it.
But what's the point of the gist of her coming out now about it? When is it because like Academic kind of like exposed it?
Ooh, Dusty Wallace with the take.
You know what I'm saying? Nah, it's real shit. Like,
no, fam, that's a great take.
You know? You know what I mean? She around Lil Wayne and all that from when she young and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
get ahead of the bullet, fam.
Yeah.
Because niggas is already looking at you crazy. Like, yo, fam, look at that, those last few Instagram lives. Exactly. Walk on.
So now she's like, okay, this is my way of putting out my story.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So she can have a book soon come out and be the bestseller.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? She knows what she's doing, though.
You think that she's still on this stuff?
Yeah, why not?
Like, because of those last few, you know, the videos that we covered the last time with her and Big Zoo and all that, well, right?
It's not to say like she on it, but the time when she got to like wild out for one night, she had a mama's night out.
Mm.
Oh, shit. They shouldn't have let her do that.
So it's not an everyday thing. It's when I get out the house.
Her and Zoo got out the house, got away from the unit, and they got in trouble.
Mm.
One night. That's all it took.
Yo, fam, one thing when it comes to this stuff, fam, just on a quick serious note.
Yeah.
When you're a rich entertainer and you have addiction problems, it must be the hardest thing in the world to kick, bro. Because it's one thing that when you're just like a regular nigga would like, you could run out of money and be like, okay, well, you know what?
You gotta stop this.
I can't do nothing tonight. Or at least I'm gonna have to do something crazy if I need to get the money to get this.
That means you're down and out then.
And that's when you know you're like, okay, all right, there might be I might do something, right? You can't find that rock bottom. It's harder to find that rock bottom when you're an entertainer because you always got the money.
Well, but you could also lose it because they get better narcotics than anybody.
Of course.
Right? Like one hit can send them to rehab for real or send them to the hospital or some shit. You know what I'm saying? So
that's not good shit.
Smoking some top tier shit.
Yeah. And whatever.
Sniffing some top tier shit.
Put them in another zone for real.
Yeah.
So you got to understand, like, they understand what they're doing, right? But it's what their character is. Maybe that's the time when they're the most in character because they always got to be speaking to people. They always got to be showing like they're happy or something, right? So then that's a way to escape the fact that I got to actually be on the red carpet tonight, but they really don't want to go.
It's got to be exhausting to be like,
it probably is, but that's what keeps them going.
Of a spotlight on you, like,
that's what keeps them going.
Yeah, fam. Like, if you might have anxiety issues or stuff like that, that might be the one thing that, you know, I can go and use that and I can go out into the public and Ray Tay Tay.
Yeah,
but like, if you know now, like, you realize to yourself, like, your people around you don't even have to tell you you got a problem.
Yeah.
You start realizing in yourself, like, damn, I got a problem.
Yeah.
But to like kick it, you're like, bro, like,
mad.
It's not even having the money.
Yeah.
It's people giving you shit too, fam.
Yeah.
When you're rich and you're famous and people,
them.
Yeah, fam, you go to the party, there's unlimited amounts of yayo, whatever around. Like, must be amazingly hard to say, all right, I'm done with this.
That's up to you if you want to keep your money now.
Yeah.
Right? Like, you could still lose your money by getting into a case, dying, anything, man.
Yeah.
So you got to be a smart person when you're in that world, in a sense too.
Yeah.
And it's money you're defending, right? That could ruin your money.
You ruin your reputation, everything, bro. You go outside too high one day, and like she did the other day.
Yeah, and then she starts doing flipping OF videos pretty much.
Yeah, she's on the couch going crazy. Now we're making podcast episodes. Like, what's wrong with her?
I'm trying to deny it for her.
Yeah, like, you know, like,
nah, man. She but that's because you're looking crazy.
Yeah, because you took too much that night, and like you have a problem, and you can't stop, bro.
And that's the thing. So this is the chance for her to reveal the story. Because we caught her.
Yeah,
red-handed.
Fam.
It's all good, though.
But the thing is, now you have to address it and stop. Like, you have
to embrace it.
She has to
embrace it, though.
But she has to kick it. You understand what I'm saying?
That's up to her. That's up to her if she wants to, like, have a future with more success, right?
She got to get that monkey off her back.
Yeah, but now they're going to know. So what they're going to do is downgrade her. Or they're going to give her more opportunities because she came out and said it.
Yeah.
Because that's still their world. You know what I'm saying? Like, some people don't fuck with people that don't even fuck with those type of things. Mm. They won't even let you in the room, right?
Yeah.
And they're more important than the person who doesn't fuck with it. So they don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? So maybe that was a way of her getting in certain rooms also.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right.
Well, listen, salute to Nicki Minaj, man. You know, pray for her, man. Like, no matter what, like, people give her this reputation of being like a mean chick, the bully and all that type of stuff. She did also say quick fast in that one of those interviews that she's been doing that she spoke to the Barbs directly to stop going at people, like, right? Even though she's the one who kind of weaponizes the Barbs a lot of times.
That's her secret weapon, like.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But she told the Barbs to stand down. So Barbs, like, if there's anything that y'all were offended by, right? Stand down. Nicki Minaj told y'all. It's not even me.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Don't come at me, Gem Barb.
Yeah. When you see this, like, leave Dusty alone.
Yeah, don't go at them.
We love hip-hop.